Alrighty, y'all. Welcome back to the show. Hope you're doing excellent. We're looking at another ride-along from a fire department, another emergency response, and this time we are in Italy. This is from a channel called Roberto Gatti, and this will be, of course, linked in the description down below so you can watch this whole video, because we're probably going to skip around and, of course, check out their channel. Let's just jump straight into that. These are always awesome. It's interesting to hear the different sirens, of course, to hear the sights and sounds of the environment, of course, the beautiful fire truck we're usually in, and most of all to see how traffic responds and what kind of lanes and passages they can come up with to get there safely, quickly, and effectively. Let's go. Okay, they're leaving the firehouse now. Look at that fleet of awesome vehicles, all in fire red. Ooh. Okay, looks like all blues for the lights. Very loud and bizarre sounding siren. That's so interesting to me, is always hearing the different sirens for different countries. And right away, traffic doing a good job. There's not too much in this right lane, thankfully. But it's always scary once you pull out and it's like, okay, it's crunch time, let's go. And you're just hoping that you don't have to weave through some really tight spots right off the bat, right? Want to ease into it. Beautiful area they're in. I have no idea where in Italy this is, but it looks pretty. This thing sounds really good too. I know it's hard to hear over the siren, but you can hear the bass of this engine, this diesel, turbo diesel. You can hear the turbo whistling big time. That was weird. You saw that car on this boulevard over here. I don't know if it was parked there for real or if it was maybe abandoned, like it broke down. Don't know. They've gotten pretty lucky so far. Their driving lane on the right here has been pretty clear. Look at those bright blue lights you can see reflecting off the signs. First big roundabout. I'd say that went pretty smooth. Pretty smooth. Doing good. God, that truck sounds good. I wish I can't see. I can't see the logo on the steering wheel. I don't know if it's a Scania or a MAN or a DAF or a Iveco. You know, perhaps it's an Iveco or a Fiat. I mean, we are in Italy after all. So these roads, shockingly, are, so far I know roads can vary. These roads are pretty big, are pretty wide. Now, on that road, what's interesting is it's kind of wide, but I don't really see lane markers. So I guess, obviously, people are usually aware and just form these lanes. Like, it looks like it could be three cars wide. But yeah, it's kind of interesting. Now there's lane markers up here, but not back there. So it's a little different. Okay, now it's getting a little more crowded. Another roundabout successful, but yeah. Gonna need some cooperation now. Yep, they got over. Good. But as you can see, I see a lot of lights up here. Ooh. He's right in the middle. And luckily, oh, come on, get over. Some of the people didn't quite get over there, but luckily oncoming traffic was low. I don't know what they're saying. Perhaps it was something like, I hope these people get the hell out of the way. Oh, man. Okay, everyone's to the right. Everyone's doing a pretty good job, actually. Traffic's being pretty reliable right now with getting out of the way. Okay, another clear path. Ooh, always scary driving through intersections. That's got to be scary. Driving over, ooh, a big bridge right now. Driving over some sort of a big river. Couple tight passes right now. Everyone's riding the shoulder. Not bad, not bad. Lots of roundabouts. That is so cool to see. I really wish, you know, some states have a lot of roundabouts, like Wisconsin does. Indiana has some. I just wish it was more common in the U.S. I think they're cool, and I think they're way more efficient than intersections with lights. Okay, so they're going pretty quick. And they've had a really smooth run so far. Although it's starting to bunch up right here. Okay, he had to wait a little bit. Come on, folks. It's such a stressful job, man. Oof. That thing sounds really good. The siren I'm not the biggest fan of. I mean, sirens are sirens, right? They're supposed to be effective, and then this one definitely would be effective. So I just kid around when I talk about what sirens sound good and what don't, or what doesn't, rather. At the end of the day, they just have to work. They have to get your attention, and that's all they're made for. Yeah, not my favorite siren ever. He had to use an additional horn there. Someone wasn't getting out of the way. But the engine on this truck sounds glorious. Sounds really good. Now he's threading the needle a little bit more up here. He's gotten more traffic. Some of the people weren't moving. That's got to be stressful. Another crazy intersection. Watch out. Oh. As always, thank you to all emergency responders. You have a brave job you got to do. And it is not for everyone, that's for sure. This is life-saving work. Uh-oh, he's got a big truck in the way. Oof. Okay, now, yeah. After that fork in the road there, he's able to clear around. Oh, I see, I didn't notice. I see he's flashing the brights down there. I mean, I'm sure they have lights and sirens running, obviously, but that's just an additional, like, hey, watch out, I'm coming through. Everyone's doing a pretty good job, honestly. Now, this is always interesting, coming up to these interchanges and junctions, especially by bigger country roads or highways even. It's just cool to see it's different than here in the U.S. For the most part. So that was a, wow, I'm, like, that confused me a little bit, how he went over and then over to the left and then over to the right again. But he knows what he's doing. Now they're cooking. They're doing some good speed for that big truck now. Okay, a little bit of traffic again. He's got a split. Oh God, you saw that car? They were not only not getting over, they looked like they were gonna go left for a second. That would have been not good. He definitely had to honk at them. Dang, everyone's doing a really good job for the most part. 9 out of 10 cars are doing great. There seems to be one kind of car that someone's not paying attention or something and they're kind of late getting over. So there seems to be one out of the bunch, but for the most part, everyone's doing an exceptional job of getting out of the way on both lanes, even oncoming traffic. Hear that thing downshift? That sounds so good. That truck. Keep going. Come on, guys. He's going pretty quick, considering he's going right through traffic. Yikes. Going really quick. Now, I wonder what that switch was. Siren? This is like a delayed switch off. That was a really good one. I would say one of the smoothest we've ever seen. So definitely the traffic wasn't nearly as heavy as some other videos like this we've seen, but there was still some bits where traffic was a little bunched up. And I have to say, considering that was like basically a 10-minute or more run, they really were smooth. I don't think they ever came to a complete stop once, if I remember right. And they hardly even slowed down to like a really slow speed. It was always moderate speed to high speed almost the whole time. So I think for the most part, they had really good cooperation from traffic, same direction and oncoming. The driver was very poised, very calm, and just efficient. They had very good sense of direction. He found the gaps super quickly and just hit them and didn't really have any close calls or anything. So that's why these are interesting, because it's a different scenario every time. You know, different cities, different roads, different traffic, different responses to that traffic. And of course, different crews, different trucks. It's really fun. Like I said, this is one of the coolest trucks we've seen yet, just for the interior is nice and the sound is top notch on this thing. The siren, not my favorite, but like I said, it is effective. All blues on this, so I'm assuming it, as we can see a little bit of the hood here. And then, of course, in the mirror, I think this is a red and white truck with blue lights. So very cool aesthetic. And yeah, just mad respect to all of emergency responders like this, especially drivers of these fire trucks, drivers of ambulances. You know, it's a very intense job, especially in those 10, 15 minutes that you're going to potentially save someone's life. You know, it's crazy. Time is of the essence in stuff like this. But equally important of saving time and being efficient is, of course, safety. Can't just drive this like a bat out of hell and cause wrecks on the way. So yeah, I think this was the smoothest one we've seen yet. I really love these suggestions and learning about these different vehicles and emergency responses, ambulance, police vehicles, police strategies. It's really cool to see. I'm really loving these. I cannot wait to hear what you guys have to say in the comments down below. What did you think of this one? If you've seen some of my other ones, do you think this was the smoothest one we've seen? I think it might be. Tell me if you agree or disagree down below. Throw a thumbs up on there if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to be part of this amazing community. My name is Ian. You watch the IWrocker, and until next time, y'all, stay safe out there. I'll catch you later.